So, are you ready for your next lesson? Well, I know that nobody likes lessons or school or shit like that, but considering you are my ghoul now, I can't just let you go around having your mortal powers, your mortal life, no. If you're going to be my ghoul, I want you to be something even more special than that you already are. Now, we just had a demonstration of feeding, which you should know how that looks like by now, so I'd guess that was more for my benefit, but I promise we will get into some useful shit. So, there are a lot of kindreds that do not know this, but it is entirely possible for mortals to develop sort of disciplines that we kindreds almost always know, at least a couple. I think a lot of us just don't like to admit to it because they would want to see mortals as weak blood bags. Well, I mean, some are, but not all of them, and they do hold some power and strength, especially if they can devote themselves to it. Now, I know you've been asking a lot about my disappearing powers. Obfuscate is what I like to call it. It is a trick of the mind, a way to manipulate someone into believing that they cannot see you. You've seen me done it before, or rather, haven't. Just like that. It's pretty easy, really, to just slip into the shadows. So, today I want to prepare you for this discipline. I think you might be able to catch at least the basics of it. So where do we start? So, as you get stronger and stronger in this art of obfuscation, you can disappear in many ways, but what most start with is the ability to stay hidden as long as you don't move. Focus yourself in one place. Project yourself into the mind of anyone. Make them believe there's nothing there. As you get stronger in this discipline, you can even find yourself invisible, even if you do move. Further on, you can even change your face, your voice, to deceive, to blend in, to manipulate. And that's a fun one. As you get stronger and stronger, you can disappear right in front of someone's face. As you get stronger, you can even conceal a whole group of people. And beyond that, for the elders among us, they've got powers that even I cannot even dream from. erasing your existence from reality itself, or even obscure someone else against their wishes. Very interesting stuff. So those are the basics of what you need to know, what you can do with Obfuscate. I was never a great teacher, but I'm willing to try with you. So the most important thing about mastering this skill is to truly remember that this is a trick of the mind. Cameras will still see you, etc. You have to focus first on one person. Not everyone in a room or street or anything like that. But first you start out with one person. Now for you, well, we could train together, but it would be a lot harder for you to deceive me. So I want you to try to hide yourself from, well, maybe not someone in your life, but anyone, stranger. It would help if you are alone with that person. Maybe hide in a park somewhere late at night. Have someone pass you by and try to remain utterly invisible. So, you will do this, and as this person approaches you from a distance, you're going to have a keen eye, which thankfully, due to my blood, you have. You will focus on this person coming from a distance. You'll focus deeply on their mind. You'll try to pretend you are them. Try to see the world from their point of view. Try to imagine being in their body and their mind, taking in what they see around them. And try to imagine yourself in there. Really get in to their perception of you. And then, when you are focused enough, you try to erase that. You focus on erasing yourself from their perception as you are sitting or standing there in that park. Focus on them. Force yourself out of their perception. You gotta stand in a way that they will see you otherwise. But when they walk past you, they have to keep looking straight ahead. Not as much as cast a glance in your direction. They have to walk straight ahead and not see you. And then once they are past, of course, you can come back here or do whatever, but I want you to try this a couple times. The first times this might not work, but that's okay. You gotta practice. It's like an exercise. You're training a muscle. And once you start getting the hang of this, you can try it while moving. Just keep a good eye on where their eyes are moving to, and make sure they do not lock on you at any point while you're moving, etc., etc. We'll go over that when we get there, but first I want you to try this. It'll be good. And, of course, I will be watching your progress. From the shadows, you have no idea that I was even there. That's a good goal. So, off you go. make me proud.